Way, way deep underground in South Africa, miners found something that just shouldn't exist. Little groove spheres, pulled from rock that's 3 billion years old. And they look, well, they look like they were made by someone. This has sparked one of the most incredible puzzles in history.
So what's the deal with them? Are these little spheres the last remaining proof of a civilization that vanished billions of years before the first dinosaur ever walked the Earth? Or is the truth something even stranger and way more amazing? Okay, let's get into it.
Alright, so our story starts in the pyrophyllite mines of South Africa. Miners are digging through this super soft rock, and they start finding these strange little objects. Some are perfectly round, others are kind of flattened, but a lot of them have these very distinct, parallel grooves running right around the middle. Now the rock itself is ancient, but how ancient is where this whole story goes from weird to truly mind-blowing.
To really get your head around this, you have to understand the enormous scale of time we're talking about. I mean, forget ancient Egypt. The dinosaurs, they showed up 230 million years ago. The first humans, only about 2 million years ago. These spheres are dated to 3 billion years ago. That's not just before people, it's before there was any complex life on this planet at all. So how on Earth could anything that looks machined exist back then?
And that massive, unimaginable time gap is exactly why these spheres just completely captured everyone's imagination. I mean, think about it. If science tells you no intelligent life existed, but you're holding what looks like a little metal ball bearing, what are you supposed to think? To a lot of people, the answer was obvious. Our history books have to be wrong. And the stories about these spheres got pretty wild.
The claims were just out of this world. People said they were perfectly balanced. So perfect, they must have been made in zero gravity. The material? Some kind of weird nickel-steel alloy not from this planet. They were supposedly harder than steel. You couldn't even scratch them. Those grooves? Way too precise to be natural. But the craziest claim? Get this. One was apparently seen spinning, all by itself, locked inside a museum display case.
You know, people who really champion this idea, like the authors of the book Forbidden Archaeology, they put forward this really dramatic theory. They call these things out-of-place artifacts, or OOP arts. For them, this isn't just some weird rock. It's actual physical proof of a super high-tech civilization that lived and died in our planet's deepest, darkest past.
So of course, faced with these unbelievable claims, science had to open its own case file. Geologists, mineralogists, you name it, they all started taking a closer look, pushing past the fantastic stories to see what the hard evidence really said. It was time to stop treating this like a myth and start treating it like a crime scene, with a story written in stone.
Because that's the bottom line, isn't it? When you strip away all the speculation, the weird stories, what do these little spheres actually have to say for themselves? Well, to figure this out, we need one simple scientific idea.
And that idea is called concretion. Now, it sounds complicated, but it's not. It's actually a brilliant little process that solves this whole mystery. Just imagine a bunch of wet mud or sand. If minerals in the water start to harden around one little central speck, like a grain of sand, they can grow outwards in every direction, kind of like a snowball rolling downhill. And if the conditions are just right, what you end up with is a nearly perfect sphere. It's not built, it's grown.
And with that one key idea, concretion, we can start to piece together what really happened. It turns out, nature has its own incredible recipe for making these things. So let's put on our detective hats and use that recipe to look at those extraordinary claims one by one.
Okay, so let's line them up. Claim versus fact. The claim? They're all perfectly round. The fact? Nope. They come in all shapes, from spheres to squished discs. Claim? They're harder than steel. Fact? Actually, they're pretty soft. You can scratch them with a piece of glass. That alien alloy? Sorry, just common earth minerals like pyrite and hematite. And the spinning sphere? Well, the museum curator confirmed the display case was always vibrating from nearby mining explosions. Case closed on that one.
And when scientists actually analyzed what these things are made of, that whole alien alloy story just completely fell apart. What they found were common iron compounds, pyrite, hematite, and other totally normal minerals. And that special nickel-steel alloy, it makes up a big fat 0%. Yeah. The exotic metal idea just vanishes under a microscope.
Okay, but that still leaves the biggest mystery, right? What about those grooves? I mean, they look so perfectly machined. Well, the secret isn't a machine. It's the ancient mud where they grew up. See, that mud was laid down in layers over time. As the concretion grew outwards, it grew really fast through the gritty, coarse layers of mud. but when it hit a fine, dense layer, its growth slowed way down. And the result? A natural groove forms exactly where that fine layer of mud was. The groove isn't something carved on it, it's a fossilized map of the ground it grew in.
So when you put all the pieces together, the verdict is pretty clear. But listen, this isn't some boring, disappointing debunking. In fact, the truth is way, way cooler than the myth. These spheres aren't a message from a lost civilization, they're a message from a lost world, our own. These things formed in a shallow volcanic lake 3 billion years ago. The planet was incredibly young, and the only life around was tiny little microbes. These spheres are a literal snapshot of that ancient world. They tell us about the chemistry of the water and what the earliest, simplest life on our planet was up to. They aren't a mystery that defies history, they're a geological treasure.
And that's the real takeaway here. The Klerksdorp spheres don't challenge what we know. If anything, they prove how powerful our scientific tools have become. We can look at a weird rock, figure out exactly how it formed, and read a story from a time so distant it's almost impossible to imagine. It's the history of our own planet, told by the planet itself.
Which leaves us with one last really cool thought. If a simple little grooved sphere can hold the story of Earth from 3 billion years ago, what other amazing stories are still out there, just waiting to be read in the rocks right under our feet?